Kapamilya. Today is Tuesday of the 28th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. If you, O Lord, should mark iniquities, Lord, who could stand? But with you is found forgiveness, O God of Israel.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray at all times, go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, for freedom Christ set us free. So stand firm and do not submit again to the yoke of slavery. It is I, Paul, who am telling you that if you have yourselves circumcised, Christ will be of no benefit to you. Once again, I declare to every man who has himself circumcised that he is bound to observe the entire law. You are separated from Christ, you who are trying to be justified by law. You have fallen from grace. For through the Spirit, by faith, we await the hope of righteousness. For in Christ Jesus, neither circumcision nor uncircumcision counts for anything, but only faith working through love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord.
Let your mercy come to me, O Lord.
Let your mercy come to me, O Lord, your salvation according to your promise.
Let your mercy come to me, O Lord.
Take not the word of truth from my mouth, for in your ordinances is my hope.
Let your mercy come to me, O Lord.
And I will keep your law continually, forever and ever.
Let your mercy come to me, O Lord.
And I will walk at liberty, because I seek your precepts.
Let your mercy come to me, O Lord.
And I will delight in your commands, which I love.
Let your mercy come to me, O Lord.
And I will lift up my hands to your commands and meditate on your statutes.
Let your mercy come to me, O Lord.
Alleluia, hallelujah. The word of God is living and effective, able to discern reflections and thoughts of the heart. Alleluia, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After Jesus had spoken, a Pharisee invited him to dine at his home. He entered and reclined at table to eat. The Pharisee was amazed to see that he did not observe the prescribed washing before the meal. The Lord said to him, O you Pharisees, although you cleanse the outside of the cup and the dish, inside you are filled with plunder and evil. You fools, did not the maker of the outside also make the inside? But as to what is within, give alms and behold, everything will be clean for you. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today, this is like an introduction. Or it is an introduction, no? Because in the coming, until Thursday, I believe, no, in the next 2 days, three including this day, we will be reading the woes. There are six woes in the Gospel of St. Luke. And in the Gospel of Matthew, I believe there are seven woes. These are directed towards the religious authority of that time, no? The first three woes, especially against the Pharisees, no? And here you have almost like the introduction, no? The context setting, no? If you notice, he was invited to the house of a Pharisee, no? And then the first thing that they noticed was that he did not observe the ritual washing. These leaders, these Pharisees, scholars of the laws, and the scribes are very particular about the letter of the law, so to speak, no? And let me invite you to reflect on 3 points. So number one, no? So that is the overall context. Number one, you realize how sensitive Christ is to the reactions of people. So the number one point, no? And then number two, the Lord criticizes the externals of the Pharisees or the religious authority of the time. They like the externals. And if you will notice in the coming days, you will see that. No? And I guess the Filipino word is very vivid, palabas, no? Nagpapalabas. It's all about externals. And then the third and last point is that, you know, the Lord says, no, what is within us, that is what is important. And what is within bears fruit in the good acts that we do externally, ad intra, ad extra. No? So let's take a look at the 3 points for our reflection. No? Una nga, ito nga yung konteksto ng Ebanghelyo nitong darating na Miyerkules, bukas at sa Webes. Ano? Ito yung pagtutuligsa ng Panginoon sa mga pinuno ng relihiyon nung panahon na yun, pinuno ng simbahan nung panahon na yun. Una sa lahat ngayon, sinasabi niya na, una sa lahat, makikita natin kung gaano kasensitibo ang Panginoon. Naramdaman niya kagad, nakutuban niya kung ano yung nasa kalooban nung host niya. No? Tapos yung pangalawa natin, pagninilayan, ay makikita natin na, yun nga, na puro palabas, yun ang sinasabi ng Panginoon. At yung pangatlo, huling punto ay, sinasabi niya, ang kabutihan mula sa kabutihan ng ating kalooban noong nagmumula ang mga mabuting gawa. First, about the sensitivity of Christ. No? If you notice, the gospel tells us, no, the Pharisee, the host, was amazed that he did not observe the ritual washing. The Lord must have sensed with his reaction, his body language, and immediately he responds to that. No, I think that's very important. No, that's very important, especially in doing ministry or in doing service or in doing anything. No, that is an interaction with people, an encounter with people. It's important that we are very sensitive. No. Not sensitive in the negative sense that we're very, very hurt right away or we are sensitive in terms of we react right away. But it is the sensitivity of empathy, of being able to sense what is going on and to empathize, no, with people. And here the Lord very clearly shows that. And you know, here it seems it's a negative sense. He sends something negative. But remember, in many cases, no, his acts of compassion, his miracles begin with empathy, with a tremendous amount of sensitivity and empathy. Siguro yung unang punto na yan, no? Pinapakita ng Panginoon na malalim ang kanyang ang ganda nung ano, for me yung Tagalog word, maganda yung sensitivity, yung kanyang kutob. Malalim at malinaw, no? At makatotohanan ang kanyang kutob, ang pagkutob sa tao. Siguro mahalaga yun, ano? Lalo-lalo na sa ating pakikitungo sa ating kapwa. And because of this sensitivity, the Lord immediately knew that they were having evil thoughts. And many instances in the gospel that we saw that, no? That the Lord knew what was going on in their minds, no? Even before they would say anything or do anything. And here, because of that, you know, the Lord was able to speak very bluntly, no? He says, "Oh, you Pharisees! No, it's you hypocrites." No, he was saying that. And here he says, "Oh, you Pharisees! You cleanse the outside, but inside you are filled with plunder and evil." And then later on, as we will see in some of the woes, he criticizes that it's all about externals. The Tagalog word is lahat palabas, walang sinceridad, walang malalim na sinceridad, kundi lahat ay palabas. That it is all for show, so to speak. It is all external. So that is the reaction of the Lord, no? And then the third and final point that I'd like you to reflect on, because this for me is one of the goals actually of prayer life and of a genuine spiritual life. It is integrity, the integrity of our persons, that what is inside us is aligned with what is externally showing, what is externally manifesting. And as the Lord says here, you know, that he says here, did not the maker of the outside also make the inside? But as to what is within, give alms, and behold, everything will be clean for you. And siguro yun yung sa Tagalog, di ba, yung ating mabuting kalooban. Na mula sa mabuting kalooban, nagbubunga ang mabuting gawa. Mula sa mabuting kalooban, ay nagmumula ang mga pagtulong sa kapwa. And I think this is, for me, one of the great goals of our prayer and spiritual life, that integrity of our person. Ultimately, holiness is about integrity, yung kabuuan ng ating pagkatao. And today, as we begin really these 3 days of the Lord criticizing the religious authorities, there's also one thing that I wish you to remember as we go through these next 3 days. The Lord in His criticism most certainly shows what authenticity He has, because the Lord will not criticize if He Himself is not following or observing what He says. So today, let us begin, in a sense, this three-day journey of trying to really reflect very deeply into ourselves, reflect on our own integrity, and see how much of that is aligned with the Lord's holiness and integrity. Let us continue our Mass, and let us now offer our prayers. Conscious of our unworthiness, we raise our minds and hearts to God the Father and present our needs before Him.
That the Church, especially its leaders, may take to heart the task of renewal and reconciliation, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government officials may show sincere concern for justice, dignity, and unity, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the media personnel may lead the people to the truth and promote the gospel values, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all of these, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together now, let us offer our prayer for our nation. Panginoon ng kasaysayan, sa aming paghahanda para sa 125th anibersaryo ng pagsilang ng aming bansa, sabayan mo po kami sa aming proyekto na magtatag ng 1,000 ng may tunay na kalayaan para sa lahat. Kalayaang nakaugat sa pagkalinga, hustisya at katotohanan. Kalayaan mula sa kahirapan na nag-aalis mula sa nakararami ng pagkakataong mapabuti ang kanilang buhay. Kalayaan mula sa gutom, kawalan ng tirahan, at kakulangan ng dekalidad ng mga simpleng serbisyo sa pangangalaga ng kalusugan at sa edukasyon. Kalayaan mula sa panlilinlang, kasinungalingan at manipulasyon. Kalayaan upang maging mga aktibo at positibong tagapagbuo ng aming bansa. Bigyan mo kami ng katatagan ng loob at inspirasyon na walang humpay na ituguyod ang isang bansang tunay na malaya para sa lahat ng mga Pilipino. Amen. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love, we celebrate His death. With living faith, we proclaim His resurrection. With unwavering hope, we await His return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer for an end to the pandemic and to rebuild our nation.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to ask for your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. Bless all those who helped see us through the challenges the pandemic brought, those who tirelessly worked to render genuine service, especially to those who suffered the most. Guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission and to end this pandemic. Heal all who are afflicted. Grant eternal rest to those who died and consolation to their loved ones. As we move forward, grant us the grace to see clearly, choose well, and act right in order to build a nation closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, faith, hope, compassion, and love. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now offer our prayer for peace, joy, and hope for our world. Father in heaven, to you we offer this prayer in the words of the Holy Father, Pope Francis. We have so much to do, and we must do it together. In the darkness of the conflicts we are living through, each of us can become a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. To us Christians, the future has a name and its name is hope. It is the virtue of the heart that does not lock itself up, does not dwell on the past, and not only survives the present but is able to see tomorrow. Bless our world, Father, with the peace, joy, and hope that the cross and resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus, won for us. For all those affected by calamities natural and man-made, for all those who suffer from the structural injustices of our time, amen. Our Lady, Mother of God, and Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Marami pong salamat and have a good day ahead and let's continue to pray the rosary. Marami pong
ang alay kapwa para sa katarungan at kapayapaan ay ang kabuuan at layunin ng Episcopal Commission on Social Action, Justice and Peace. Ang layunin at ng katarungan at kapayapaan ay tanggalin ang di makatarungang istruktura sa lipunan na nakikita natin sa pamagitan ng paglabag sa dangal at karapatan ng mamamayan at kalikasan na nagdudulot ng kahirapan at paghihirap ng mga tao at nagpapatuloy ng di pagkapantay-pantay sa lipunan, kapangyarihan, pamahalaan at pakitungo sa kapwa. Bilang programa kasama sa Alay para sa Katarungan ang Mabuting Pamamahala o Good Governance, isang halagang parte para sa panlipunang katarungan or social justice. Ang diin ng programa ay upang itaguyod at ipatupad ang dignidad o dangal at karapatan ng mga tao sa pamamagitan ng pakikilahok sa pamamahala. At gusto din ng inito mag-ambag para sa pagbabago ng struktura, sistema na kaaya-aya o conducive para sa ikabubuti ng nakararami.